Okay, let's work on the C major scale. This should be should say scale master quarter notes. All right, this first key in the scale, we're going to learn from it. There are no accidentals in this key signature. There's no sharps or flats. And I have other videos that talk about why major scales look that way. But for right now, we're just going to say, hey, this is what a C major scale is. These are the notes in the key of C. Now, this scale we're going to learn, I'm not actually covering the entire scale in the key of C because we're only using the top four notes, the E, B, G, and D string. We're not going to utilize the lower two strings, the A and the E string. We're just going to use these top four here, all right, for the scale. So that means we're not going to go down as low as you would eventually or normally to play a C major scale. So we're going to start on this first note, C, which is the first fret. Use your one finger, your pointing finger there. Now we're going to go quarter notes. I'm just going to go walk right up and then right down. And this is actually scales going from G to G. But anyway, let's try this. This is actually a Mixolydian scale, actually. But anyway, starting on C. Ready and play. And one, D, and E. Good enough, just those three measures. Do it again, all downstrokes. And when you downstroke with the pick, you're touching the next string. I mean, until you're using the high E string, then you just go a little distance. You don't swoosh it away. You just go doop doop. But when you're coming down and you hit that D, C, rest your pick against the next string. Here we go. Let's try it again. All right. Ready and play. And now, when you're playing your left hand, you want to keep your fingers as close to the strings as possible. You don't want your fingers flying up because you'll lose your place. Keep your fingers, practice keeping your fingers right above the strings. So when you play it, you lift it up. You don't lift it up very far. You just lift up just enough to let the string relax it. You know, just don't let your fingers fly out. Keep them right there. All right, let's practice that. Here we go. Ready and play. And keep your fingers close. Do it again. Ready and play. And C, D. Keep your fingers close. G, F, E, D, C, B, A. Do it again. Keep these fingers up here on the frets. Keep them close to the strings. Don't let your fingers fly up. Ready and play. And do it again. Ready and play. And all right, let's do it again one more time. Just those three measures. Ready and play. And now let's move on to measure the next section of five measures. Now we're playing a little melody with the notes that we just played in the scale. We're going to start on the A. All right, so your second fret, second finger. Make sure every finger has a fret, right? First finger, first fret. Second fret. Third finger, third fret. Fourth finger, fourth fret. Takes a little practice, just getting those stretched out. But get a little bit of time, you can do that. Don't cheat. Here we go. Start on the A with your second finger. We're going to walk it right up. Ready and play. And A, B, Hold for two beats. Now E. E. Back to C. A. C. And then to the D. F. And G. Back to B. C. G. A. For two beats. And then B. D. C. B. D. C. All right. Let's try it again. Start on the A. Ready and play. And A, B, C, and four. And E, C, A, C, F, G, B, C, G, A, B, D, C. Now, that second measure we're playing, that E, C, A, C, C. That's actually an A minor triad. But don't play the notes with the A minor position with your guitar for a chord. Don't use that. Because that's different than playing a melody. So don't use your three finger over here to play the E or the A. Use your two finger. That's what you do when you're playing the melody. When you're playing a melody or a lead guitar part or any kind of when you're finger picking and you're using notes, you're going to mostly when you're playing a melody or whatever or those type of things, you're going to be using your two finger there. Yeah. Yes, when you're playing a chord, you might be doing that. Yes, but that's not what we're learning right now. We're learning something a little different. So. All right, let's start there again on measure five, or whatever it is, A B C. A B C. Ready and play. And A, B, C, and four, and then D, F, G, B, C, G, A, B, D, C. All right. Let's just try the first, those first two measures. A, B, C, E, C, A, C. There we go. Ready and play. And do it again. Two, three, and four. And do it again. Two, ready and play. And all right, now let's go to the next measure. On that D, C, G, B. Ready? Play that for me. Ready and play. And D, C, G, B. Do it again. Ready and play. D, F, G, B. I might have said that wrong note the first time. Ready and again. Ready and play. And D, F, G, B. All right, let's play all three measures. A, B, C, okay? Ready and play. Now, last two measures. Ready and play. Measures to ready and play and ba, da, 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 da. All right, now let's try to play the whole thing, the scale and the melody. All right, from the top. There we go. Start on the C to ready and play. C. Two, ready and play. C, D, F, G, F, G, D, C, D, A, G, F. One more time. And I'm not going to sing this time and say their notes wrong. One, two, three, four, and... There's a look at C major, key of C major, and the C major scale.